Jimmy Butler is an NBA player that has famously beat the odds in life to become one of the league's best. His story is a true example of triumph over adversity. Some have had to break many barriers socially, physically, and mentally in order to reach the top. This can serve as an inspiration to those who wish to achieve their dreams but are filled with doubt as to whether or not it's possible. Today, we're discussing all the fascinating facts about Jimmy Butler. You don't want to miss this.
But first, a simple reminder on how to enter our brand new giveaway. We will be giving away either an iPhone X Max, the new iPad Mini, or a MacBook Pro. It's all your choice. So be sure to leave a like, comment the keyword, subscribe, and turn on notifications to enter the giveaway. It's really that simple.
First, let's talk about Jimmy Butler's background. Jimmy Butler was born in September 1989 in Houston, Texas. He's 31 years old. As mentioned, he's overcome some crazy adversity in his life. Butler's dad abandoned his family when he was just a baby. When Butler was 13 years old, his mother kicked him out of their house saying, "I don't like the look of you. You gotta go." Who has ever heard of something so odd? He had no support or guidance from his family in becoming great. As unbelievable as that sounds, what's even more unbelievable is that he currently has a close relationship with his parents. He's been quoted as saying, "I don't hold grudges. I still talk to my family, my mom, my father, we love each other. That's never going to change." Butler got a pair of highly valued Air Jordan basketball shoes when he was in grade school. He was apparently so happy to get them, he spent most of his time admiring them rather than wearing them. He only had the chance to wear them about 4 times before he grew out of them and couldn't get them on anymore. After Butler left home, he was forced to move around a lot. He stayed with friends for weeks at a time and as a result had a difficult time growing up. Despite this, he managed to develop as an athlete. He was eventually able to find a stable home later in high school with his friend Jordan Leslie's family. The two met when Leslie challenged Butler to a 3-point shooting contest. Butler is known to have had the odd habit of eating dessert before meals. It's not clear where or when he picked up his habit, but given the fact that he spent a sizable portion of his childhood without parents, it's not surprising he acts a bit childish at times. Jimmy Butler went to Tomball High School in Tomball, Texas. He played for the school's basketball team where as a junior he averaged 10 points per game. He improved his skills quite a bit from his junior to senior year, which would be a continued characteristic throughout his career. His senior year he averaged 19.9 points per game and 8.7 rebounds per game as team captain. As a result, he was voted the team MVP. Next, let's talk about Jimmy Butler's college basketball career. Unlike most other famous NBA players, Butler was not highly sought after by colleges for their basketball teams when he left high school. This resulted in him attending Tyler Junior College in Tyler, Texas, where he, of course, continued to play basketball on the school's team. His freshman year, he averaged 18.1 points, 7.7 rebounds, and 3.1 assists per game. His performance finally got him some attention from recruiters at the Division I level. He was only considered a 2-star recruit and was listed as the number 127th junior college prospect in 2008. In Butler's sophomore year, he received a scholarship to play basketball and study at Marquette University in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. That year, he averaged 5.6 points and 3.9 rebounds per game. The next year, he was able to join the starting lineup, where he greatly improved his stats. His junior year, he averaged 14.7 points and 6.4 rebounds per game. He also managed to win 2 games with shots against UConn and St. John's. For the 2009-2010 season, he earned all Big East honorable mention honors, and his team finished 11-7 in wins versus losses in the Big East. The Golden Eagles had their 5th consecutive NCAA tournament appearance as well. In his last year of college with Marquette, he averaged 15.7 points per game, which led to a 2nd consecutive All-Big East honorable mention for Butler. At Marquette during the 2010-2011 season, Butler played on the same team as Jimmy and Jay Crowder, who are affectionately known as Batman and Robin. That year, the team made it to the Sweet 16. They recently reunited while playing for the Miami Heat, where they managed to go all the way to the 2020 NBA Finals. Next, let's talk about Jimmy Butler's attributes. Butler is 6 feet 7 inches tall. He weighs 230 pounds. He usually plays the position of small forward. Small forward is called the 3 out of the 5 positions in basketball. Small forwards are usually shorter, quicker, and leaner than power forwards and centers, but taller, larger, and stronger than guards. It's known as the most versatile position on the court. Their job is to score as well as defend. They also need good passing skills and sometimes can be high scorers. The way small forwards score can be quite different, which means they either favor accuracy or pushing through the other players, for example. Some famous small forwards include Julius Irving, Larry Bird, Scottie Pippen, Dominique Wilkins, and LeBron James, who's considered by many to be the best player to ever play that position. Butler is known first and foremost for his aggressive playing style. He's been compared to a football linebacker linebacker or even a sledgehammer. He's known for driving straight through players to the basket. This has helped him become a prolific scorer throughout his career. On top of that, he's a strong defender who relies heavily on his strength on the court. Next, let's talk about the beginning of Butler's NBA career and his time with the Bulls. Jimmy Butler was selected as the 30th overall pick in the first round of the 2011 NBA draft. He started his career in Chicago playing for the Bulls. His first season, he was only able to play 42 games due to the lockout. During his second season in 2012-2013, he was able to play in every one of the team's 82 games. He didn't play much in the first half of the season, but the second half was his time to shine. He started in all 12 of the Bulls' playoff games. On April 9th of that season, he scored 28 points against the Toronto Raptors, which was the most in his career at that time. Then, just a couple of days later, he managed to record his first career 2010 game with 22 points and 14 rebounds while playing the New York Knicks. Butler's 2013-2014 season with the Bulls, he continued to improve despite missing 15 games due to an injury. That year, he scored the most points on December 30th against the Memphis Grizzlies. He also set a franchise record on January 15th by playing over 60 minutes in a triple overtime game with the Orlando Magic. That year, he averaged the most minutes per game of his career with 38.7, ranking first in the league. For his efforts, he was named the NBA All-Defensive Second Team. In 2013, Butler met Mark Wahlberg at a pickup game. They're now good friends. Wahlberg inspired Butler with how hard he works, which led him to using his techniques in his training regimen. In the 2014-2015 season, Butler hit a new career high, scoring 35 points against the New York Knicks. He was named the Eastern Conference Player of the Month in December as well. Then, in January 2015, he was named a reserve for the Eastern Conference in the 2015 NBA All-Star Game. An injury kept him off the court for a few weeks, but when he returned, he was back to scoring highly and getting many rebounds. He hit another milestone in the playoffs by scoring 33 points during the postseason against the Milwaukee Bucks. He was named the 2014-2015 NBA Most Improved Player, which was the first time anyone on the Bulls had won that award. The 2015-2016 season, Butler unleashed his true potential. He scored 43 points on December 18th against the Detroit Pistons. Then on January 3rd, he broke a record set by Michael Jordan when he scored 40 points in one half against the Toronto Raptors. After that, he scored a career high of 53 points against the Philadelphia 76ers, which made him the first Bull to score more than 50 points since 2004. He had a knee injury before the 2016 NBA All-Star Game, which kept him from playing. Then, on April 2nd, he recorded his first triple-double of his career, with 28 points, 17 rebounds, and 12 assists against the Detroit Pistons. The 2016-2017 season, Butler continued his dominant play on the court with numerous high-scoring games. He scored 52 points on January 2nd against the Charlotte Hornets. Then on January 7th, he had 40 points or more for the third time in six games. He was named a starter on the Eastern Conference All-Star team for the 2017 NBA All-Star Game. Next, let's talk about the last few years of Butler's career. Butler was traded to the Minnesota Timberwolves in June 2017. He scored a season-high 39 points in December of that year against the Denver Nuggets. He opted to not play in the All-Star Game and rest instead. A knee injury kept him out of many games for the rest of the year. Butler requested a trade before training camp in 2018, but ended up playing 10 games before it eventually happened. He was traded to the Philadelphia 76ers and played for them for the remainder of the 2018-2019 season. That year, his highest scoring game was 38 points against the Toronto Raptors on December 5th, which he then equaled in the next game against the Detroit Pistons. The team made it to the playoffs, but was quickly defeated. In July 2019, Butler was traded to the Miami Heat, where he once again began to excel. He was named to his fifth NBA All-Star game on January 30th, 2020. Butler reached the NBA Finals for the first time in 2020. In the third game, he scored 40 points with 11 rebounds and 13 assists, which made him the third player in Finals history to record an over 40-point triple-double, a distinction he coincidentally shares with LeBron James, who plays for the LA Lakers, the team the Heat was playing against in the Finals. Then, in Game 5 of the Finals, Butler had 35 points, 12 rebounds, 11 assists, and 5 steals, which is the first time any player has reached those numbers in the Finals. Butler then tied LeBron James once again in the Finals by becoming the only other player besides him to have multiple 30-point triple-doubles in the same series. Regardless of his strong effort, the Heat fell to the Lakers in Game 6. Well, that wraps up our video about all the fascinating facts about Jimmy Butler. We'll see you next time.